Welcome to Daily Thoughts for March 23rd on peaceworks.tv. My name's Stephen Jarnick, and today's topic is Rationalizing Miracles. Let's start by looking at the book of John, chapter 6, verses 10 and 11. Jesus said, "Have the people sit down." There was plenty of grass in that place, and the men sat down, about 5,000 of them. Jesus then took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed to those who were seated as much as they wanted. I'm sure everyone already knows this story. It's a story of Jesus feeding the 5,000 with 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fish. I'd say that's one heck of a miracle. But sometimes people have trouble accepting stuff like this, and they try to rationalize it. The thinking kind of goes, Jesus couldn't possibly have done what this story says he did, so there must be some other explanation. I once listened to someone give a sermon on this, and their take on it was that everyone was sort of deferring to the next person. Nobody wanted to appear greedy, so they just say, "Oh, I'm fine, thanks," and pass the food on to the person next to them. This preacher was pretty confident that he had it all figured out. There was no miracle here. It was just people taking the good advice of Jesus and being other-centered. Now, there are 2 major problems with this guy's point of view. First, it assumes that Jesus is not God and that he's just some guy that teaches people good things. And second, it makes absolutely no sense at all if you just keep reading. In verses 12 and 13, it says, "When they'd all had enough to eat, he said to his disciples, 'Gather the pieces that are left over, let nothing be wasted.' So they gathered them and filled 12 baskets with the pieces of the 5 barley loaves left over by those who had eaten." So there goes the pass it on unselfishly theory right out the window. Unless you want to continue making up your own story, and then I guess they could be little tiny microscopic baskets that could only hold a couple of crumbs. But that would be silly, as was his interpretation. Unfortunately, us Christians are often guilty of viewing Jesus this way. We don't want to accept him as God, we second-guess his teachings, and we think we know better. And this is especially true of his peace teachings. We say to ourselves, surely he can't mean love your enemies in every situation. But the simple truth is that he does. And I'd say that's a greater miracle than this whole loaves and fishes thing. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, please give us the faith to have absolute trust in what you say and do through Jesus. So often we look at everything from our perspective when we should be looking at it from yours. We pray that you'll help us and guide us as we continue on our faith journey. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.